I got my start in the industry by working at a small public course outside of Chicagoland in West Chicago called Prairie Landing Golf Club. Just basically looking for free golf.
I got my start in the industry, I guess you could probably say maybe around 8 years ago. I was doing some landscaping for a local company and came across a golf course here called Center Hills in State College and fell in love with it.
Kind of got my start on accident, really. I was doing my undergrad at Indiana University of Pennsylvania, and we had to do an internship for a sports management major, and someone recommended a golf course, and I thought, oh, that would be easy. So I applied to a couple golf courses. I ended up going to Oakmont Country Club, just outside of Pittsburgh.
Ooh, my start, let's see, I started in 2011, right out of high school. My buddy, actually, his father worked as a security guard, and he asked if I wanted a job at the golf course that he worked at, and I figured, why not? I need a summer job, and things just kind of progressed from there.
Made a career change. I left the dental prosthetics industry and wanted to jump over and do something that I had a lot of pride and passion in, and I was fortunate enough to find that in the turf grass management industry.
Well, I'm 32, making a career change. I got sick of sitting behind a desk, started working on a golf course, and decided to come to Penn State.
I chose Penn State because after deciding I wanted to do this as a career, I did a lot of research into what schools I should go to, and I discovered that Penn State has the best reputation and has a very large alumni base.
After graduating, there's a global reach with this university and not a lot of other turf grass programs can say that.
Both my bosses are graduates of the two-year program, so they're big advocates for it, and really in my mind there was no other option. The prestige that this program is known for is truly second to none.
I chose Penn State because of the superintendent at Ozaukee Country Club. He highly recommended the program.
It was a pretty obvious choice, the reputation they have, and makes a lot more sense for me to go to the best turf school in the world that's in my backyard.
I chose Penn State because I was working at Potsdam Town and Country Club up in New York, and the superintendent, Mike Vella, he taught me a lot, and he kind of took me under his wing, and you know, I told him one day I was thinking about getting into this instead of going back and doing my undergrad or finishing my undergrad, and then he set me up with Dr. Kaminsky.
My favorite class at Penn State would probably have to be Dr. McNitt's soils class. Just the amount of knowledge that man knows and how he was able to teach us about it was the best.
I think my favorite class so far has been the plant pathology class with Dr. Kaminsky. It's a really cool class, and it's cool to learn about all the different turf diseases, and it's definitely something that we're going to be able to keep with us, and it's going to be an invaluable experience for our careers.
My favorite class at Penn State is probably Weeds with Jeff Borger. Definitely a lot of practical knowledge in the class and real world skills that will be applied daily.
My favorite class is probably our case studies class with Dr. Landscoot. I feel it's a great class. It kind of brings everything we've learned here in these last 17 months, everything full circle, and really makes you think about what you need to be doing on the golf course daily.
My favorite class at Penn State was Dr. Max's first soils class, first semester. Well, the Cubs won the World Series that year, and they were down 3-1, and I made a bet with Dr. Max that Cubs won the World Series, I would get extra credit on the final. We all know that how that ended for Dr. Max, so.
I did my 6-month internship at Medina in Chicago. It was a great experience. A lot of opportunity to learn between three golf courses.
My 6-month internship was a really good experience. I went to Southern Hills Country Club in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and basically it was just to get out of my comfort zone, a place I'd never been. I knew the environment was going to be rough, as far as the weather and stuff like that.
I did my internship at Valhalla Golf Club in Kentucky. The reason I went there, I just kind of wanted to throw myself out of my comfort zone. Kind of wanted to go to a different environment, and it was a really good learning experience for me. Learned a lot, made a lot of good connections there, and you know, it's certainly a place that I would like to get back to at some point.
I did my 6-month internship at Whistling Straits in Kohler, Wisconsin. I felt that was a good pick for me. I wanted a links style course, and I wanted a course that was going to be having a lot of projects going on, and they had a lot of projects. I got exposed to a lot of different facets of the golf course industry, and I felt really, really good after my internship.
So I did my 6-month internship at Wade Hampton Golf Club in Cashers, North Carolina. I chose Wade Hampton because they were doing a major renovation, greens, rough, tees, you name it, we did it. It was a good experience, and I would do it again if I could.
I went to work for the Milwaukee Brewers, actually. I wanted to try something a little different, and I figured that now is the time to do it rather than when I'm out in the real world. So definitely enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun, but I decided I wanted to return back to the golf side of the industry.
The 6-month internship was very beneficial to the guys in our class. We get there probably a month or two before any other 4-year student would, so we become acclimated with the system that they run, and then, you know, we gain our employer's trust.
My favorite memories would definitely have to be the football games. I was fortunate enough to be a part of both Ohio State and Michigan whiteouts and watch some pretty awesome wins.
The weekend after Penn State beat Ohio State really pumped this university up.
I'll give you a little story here. It was our first semester, and Mike Melka was my roommate at the Comfort Suites. And it was about 1 a.m, and I hear him wake up. And he walks into the bathroom, and I'm like, yes, whatever. And then he walks back out and grabs a bag of chips and walks back into the bathroom and starts eating the chips in the bathroom. I can just hear him munching on them. And I was just like, what is happening right now? It was like the first week that I'd ever met him, and it was just a bizarre phenomenon. Oh yeah, he was sleepwalking, absolutely, yeah.
The Tour Championship was fun because we were all in Atlanta, we were all working together, which we never had the opportunity to do, and we got to have a good bonding experience outside of the tournament.
I mean, pretty much all the memories I have are from our hotel, and they're all good. Free Beer Friday was always a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun with that. Every home football game for Penn State, the hotel we stayed at, would buy beer for everyone staying in the hotel, which would include us. And we ate all the food and drank all their beer.
My advice for somebody getting into this industry is find a high-end private club and work at it and get crushed. And you're going to find out quickly if you really want to do this or not.
To see what your boss is doing and take initiative, think 2 steps ahead, and I think if you focus on those 2 things, you're going to go far in this industry.
My advice for someone getting into the turf industry would be to work hard and don't forget to have fun, because that's why we're here, is because we love what we're doing.
We have the opportunity to work on some of the most beautiful pieces of property in the world. It really doesn't get any better than that. And the bonds you make with people in this industry, it's basically one giant family. So you can't beat it.
I accepted a assistant superintendent position at Bitterman, where I did my internship, and I'll be heading out there in March.
My plans following graduation, I'm going to be working at Baldhead Island Club, just south of Wilmington, North Carolina, in a leadership role.
Following graduation, I'm going to be returning to Discovery Land Company in a leadership role. I'm going to be kind of traveling around with the company from golf course to golf course.
My plans after graduating, I have an internship with Muirfield Village, so I'll be heading up to Dublin, Ohio, and working there for a while, so I'm excited.
So after graduation, I accepted a job in Basalt, Colorado as an AIT at the Roaring Fork Club.
I'd like to thank Pat Mishner, superintendent at the Country Club of New York, as well as Aaron Giordano, lead assistant at the Country Club of New York. They've been great mentors, and they've helped me get where I'm at this point.
Yeah, I'd like to thank Mike Sauls, because without him, I would have never pursued this industry, and I would have never been pushed to come to Penn State.
Definitely, I'd like to thank Brett Holzer, the superintendent at Ozaukee Country Club, for recommending the program to me.
I'd like to thank my girlfriend for putting up with the long distance relationship that we've been in. It's been hard for both of us, but thank you, Mariah.
I would definitely like to thank my parents and family. They've supported me through these last 18 months, and without my parents, for sure, I wouldn't be here right now.
I definitely owe a special thanks to Mike Bella for getting me introduced to this stuff and putting me in contact with Dr. Kaminsky, and also my parents for understanding that I didn't want to go back and finish my undergrad degree and kind of do a little switch up. We are Penn State.
We are Penn State.
We are Penn State.